for you, my presentation is on an outbreak investigation that we have investigated last year in Düzce. Düzce is a small province in northwest of Turkey. Bahçeköy village is away from central district of Düzce, about 6 kilometers. We have received a notification from Düzce Public Health Directorate on the 9th of June. About 37 sick people applied to Düzce Public Hospital. They attended a circumcision feast meal in Bahçeköy. They had nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, and diarrhea. Circumcision feast meal served at 11 a.m. On the 8th of June, about 3 people had eaten the meal. Lunch menu consisted of boiled chicken, pilav, rice, and packaged ayran, a drink made of yogurt and water, and tulumba dessert, a kind of pastry dessert. And we have found out that all of the people who ate the boiled chicken were sick. Our hypothesis was at least one of foods served in the feast meal caused this outbreak. We decided to investigate this event, and our investigation aimed to determine the cause or the agent, mode of transmission, and to implement control measures. We conducted a retrospective cohort study. Because this place was a little village and we could reach the population easily and quickly, we defined the cohort group as the residents who had eaten the lunch served at a feast meal. Probable cases was onset of nausea or vomiting or diarrhea at 8th of June among residents who ate the lunch served as feast meal, and we defined non-case as asymptomatic people among residents who ate the lunch served as feast meal. And here you can see the timeline of the field study. On the 8th of June, the feast meal was served, and on that day and next day, the cases began to emerge. On the 9th, Public Health Directorate reported this information to early warning and response unit. On the 10th, we went to Düzce and start to investigation. On the 11th of June, we trained interviewers and we performed preliminary interviews. Finally, on the last 2 days, we performed the questionnaire. We checked acute gastroenteritis surveillance data in early warning system for Central District of Düzce, June 2014. We found that there was no significant increase in cases and no alerts in the city. The attack rate was 16.3%. Almost half of the participants were women. Their mean age was 28. And one third of them was in 15 to 44 age group. Most common symptoms of probable cases were nausea, vomiting, and abdominal pain. First three symptom was that. And epidemic curve revealed that it was a point source outbreak. On the left, you can see time of serving meal at 11 a.m. and the first case emerged in 30 minutes after the service. Median incubation period was 6 hours. As you can see, there is one case on the right who got sick at 5 a.m. This is because this case was one of the people who took the meal home and ate it later. Preparation of chicken. The chicken was bought from a local farm on the 7th of June. Then at 4 p.m., it was boiled into large pots in the garden by three cooks. The chicken was cooled and cooled by breaking to pieces. Then it was put in the refrigerator 2.5 hours later. When it was waiting for cooling, it was kept outdoor in the garden and finally was served in the morning on the 8th June. The rice was cooked with tap water on the 8th of June. Packaged ayran and a ready-made tulumba dessert was bought at the same day. Our results, as you can see, the attack rate of people who ate chicken was the highest. There was no one who didn't eat chicken among cases. After controlling for tulumba dessert, we found out that people who ate chicken developed illness 12 times more. And the chicken sample taken on the next day of the feast lunch was tested positive for coagulase positive staphylococcus. Water sample taken from the routine sampling point of the Willis water pipe system was tested positive for coliform bacteria, E. coli, and Clostridium perfringens. One of the three cooks had Staphylococcus aureus in nasal culture. We had some limitations in the study. One of them, according to early warning and response system, there was a time delay in notification, which should have been in 24 hours. Another one, number of samples were insufficient. Only one sample of chicken could have been taken. There was no leftover rice, ayran, and tulumba dessert. Also, none of the cases had diarrhea anymore when the team arrived there. So stool samples were not available. In conclusion, this outbreak was mostly likely due to chicken contaminated with coagulase positive staphylococcus. Mode of transmission was unclear, but there was an asymptomatic cook. There were also inappropriate storage and inadequate cooling conditions. One of these could be the reason we consider that. Public and family physicians trainings on food hygiene and safety were performed. We recommended provincial food, agriculture, and livestock directorate to increase the number of periodic audits for foods. And finally, I want to take thanks to my colleagues from FETP, Dr. Dilek Cemil Göktaş, and our amazing director, Fehminaz Temel. I would also like to thank to the health workers in Düzce. Thank you for all.
Thank you very much. Any questions? Dr. Ibrahim.
It's not a question, but it's just a comment.
Okay.
Because we see this day a number of food poisoning outbreaks, food-related outbreaks, food-borne outbreaks. I suggest in the slide of objectives for my colleagues that we have to identify the source. All of them decided that they have to search about the etiology and mode of transmission, but the source has to be added to the objectives, especially in food porn, because we need to make a trace back. Sometimes we need to withdraw some products from the market, so it's important to add this to this section. Thank you.
Yes, thank you. You are right.
Thank you, Dr. Rahim. I think that one addition, if you accept that from us, that you have to do some legislation for the food handlers. Because I think that there is no legislation for being immunized or have a certificate for being food handlers. I don't know if it is present in Turkey or not.
But they are not official food handlers. They are feast meal owners' relatives. And official, we couldn't anything official.
But you have this certificate for food handlers in Turkey? You have, okay.
Yes,
that's
yes.
Fine. Okay. Uh-huh. Thank you very much.